For your health this morning, in our segment last weekend, we learned how an unhealthy, malfunctioning gut can affect our immune system and our overall health, and that what we eat influences the state of our gut microbiome. Our health expert, Karen Owok, is back this weekend to help guide us through the maze of what we actually need to be eating for optimal gut health and longevity. Karen, where do we start?
Well, first, I don't think Will got the message that it's purple day today.
He definitely didn't.
So first, we talked about our gut garden of microbes that are circulating in our digestive tract. So the foods we eat have an effect on the types of bacteria, as well as the number of bacteria, as well as the ratio of good to bad bacteria. So the first thing, we start with probiotics, and we hear a lot about probiotics. Mm-hmm. And probiotics are live cultures. They are things like yogurt. If you don't eat yogurt, we also have plant-based yogurts that you just have to make sure you look for the live active cultures in the yogurt. Also, things like miso, these fermented foods, also have live cultures in them. So these, think of probiotics as the bacteria. They are the seeds. You want to plant as many of those seeds as possible in your gut.
Okay, and kombucha and pickled vegetables as well are part of this?
Yes. So kombucha is a fermented tea, and it's fermented, so therefore it has the live cultures in it.
And you were saying there's probiotics, obviously, but then there's also something called prebiotics. What's the difference between those two?
So the prebiotics are very important, and those, think of the prebiotics as the fertilizer to these seeds. Mm-hmm. You plant the seeds, and now you need them to grow. And you need the prebiotics, and think fiber. So these high fiber foods are what your good gut bugs like. So number one, wheat. So you want to include wheat in your gut. The thing with people that follow a gluten-free diet, mm-hmm. they are not getting the benefits of the whole grain. They actually found that those that followed a gluten-free diet for 1 month had a reduction in the diversity of their gut bugs, as well as they had an increase in the bad bugs. So it really had an effect on their immune function.
So you
want to make sure you get the wheat. Also oats, make sure you fill your gut with lots of oats.
Yeah.
Those are excellent sources of fiber. Bananas are also very good. And bananas come in the whole form, or they also come now, you can also get them dehydrated and dried without any added sugars. Also really good are sweet potatoes. Mm. Sweet potatoes are a good source of fiber. So remember the sweet potatoes. Also, all the legumes, so those beans and lentils and soybeans, also very good for fertilizing your gut.
Okay. And then there's also polyphenols. Is that how you say that?
Polyphenols. Also, another note on the prebiotics, you know, the fiber, those are carbohydrates. So people that follow a very low carbohydrate diet, you know, they're following the keto or whatever, where mm-hmm. you're not eating very many carbs, you are also compromising the growth of the good gut bacteria.
Mm, so you do need that.
You do need the carbs. Yeah. Right. So the polyphenols are the beneficial compounds that are in plant foods. So they kind of overlap with the prebiotics, those fiber foods. But they also include things like tea and also include herbs. Herbs are plants. They're just very concentrated forms of plants. Spices like cinnamon and turmeric, those are also very good forms of polyphenols. These polyphenols have a lot of active compounds in them, so they help reduce chronic inflammation. So that's gonna also help you from getting chronic diseases. Dark cocoa, I'm not saying chocolate that gets people all excited.
Yeah, that's my dessert.
Ideally the dark cocoa, which doesn't have any of the powdered form, the very dark, that doesn't have the added sugars and the additives in it.
I feel like you just gave us kind of a great way to plan out our day for a healthy gut diet. We've got, for breakfast, we can do yogurt or maybe even a sweet potato for breakfast, maybe?
Yes.
And then lunch, leafy greens, or maybe a bean soup of some sort. And then dinner, you always kind of go towards, obviously, steamed vegetables on the side, of course, with salmon or something like that, right?
Right. And you can add those roasted potatoes. That's just also very good.
Awesome. So basically, you're not always talk, I feel like when people go on diets that are trying to help them be a little bit more healthier, they talk about restricting things. You're all about adding the good things.
Absolutely, and that's a good point to bring up, Noelle, because yeah, it's about what can I add to my diet to make it healthier and not thinking about taking away. Although you do want to avoid the added sugars. Added sugars, they increase inflammation. We're trying to reduce inflammation. So things like meat and the added sugars. The most important thing is to include as many things as you can and think about variety. Eating the same thing day after day after day is not going to have an influence on your microbial diversity. And that's what you want to increase. So lots of different types of good bacteria, as well as the number of good bacteria, so you outnumber the bad bacteria.
Keeping our guts healthy. Karen Owak, thank you so much. Always appreciate it.
Okay, see you next week, Noelle.